Is the end of this world intimidation? The end of this world is near, teaches Jehovah's Witnesses. Dear friends of the truth, brothers and sisters, there was a reaction on my video, is the end of this world near? They blame me of intimidation. As we really accept the Bible as our guide for the truth, then we can expect the coming of the end of this world. Is the outlook of the end of this world negative? Christ's assignment was to make known the good news of the kingdom. He let us pray, let your kingdom come. He says to Pilate, my kingdom is no part of this world. If we pray for the coming of the kingdom of God, then we must also accept that God makes before the realization of the new world an end of this bad world with all the not solved problems by the political leaders. Many ones sighing of the criminalities and the violence and say, why let God this bad world continue and make not an end of it? Peter refers to the last days and wrote that in the last days mockers will come, following after their own lusts and saying, where is the promise of his coming? It is just as it was before the beginning of creation. And in verse 10 he wrote, but the day of the Lord will come like a thief. Verse 13, we are looking for new heavens and new earth in which righteousness dwell. In verse 14 to 15, since you look for these things, be diligent to be found by him in peace, spotless and blameless, and regard the paces of our Lord as salvation. It is clear that salvation is dependent of having God's approval. That God lets exist this bad world to this day gives for many the possibility to have regret and to bring their lives in agreement with the will of God. John wrote in 1 John 2 verse 17, the world is passing away and also its lust, but the one that does the will of God lives forever. These are for many encouraging words that help them to bring their lives in agreement with the will of God and have the prospect of saving. It will be foolish to belong to the mockers that says intimidation. It is wise to have attention for what God has to say in his word, the Bible. By wars of humans are many civilian casualties. The righteous war of God by Christ Jesus and his angels is a selective war and directed to all the political systems with his armies and the ones that support them, and is also directed to the rest, as you can read in Revelation 19. The ones that would be saved are pictured in Revelation 7, verse 13 to 17. The rest in white robes that are washed in the blood of the Lamb, the sacrifice provision by Christ Jesus for forgiveness of sins with the prospect of saving. The protection for them is pictured by spreading a tent over them. We read in behalf of them, but as these things begin to take place, straighten up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. Christ's disciples expected the end of this world. The ones by Christ Jesus questioned him, as we read in Matthew 24, verse 3, and asked him, tell us, when will these things happen, and what will be the signs of your coming and the end of this world? They must have in mind Daniel 2, verse 44, that God's kingdom will make an end of all the political powers and itself will stand to time indefinite. If you read the signs in Matthew 24, Mark 13 and Luke 21, Some parts has already taken place by the destruction of Jerusalem in the year 70 CE. It must be clear for you, if you observe the fulfillment of the signs at this time, that the end of this world must be near. After the end of this world, the kingdom of God will reign over the earth, and all the consequences of the rebellion against God will be past. As we read in Revelation 21, verse 1 to 5, the new earth is then a real fact. The former earth is passing away. All the humans are then God's people. There will be no longer any mourning, or crying, or pain. There will be no longer any death. The one on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new." The expectation for you can be a bright future. This is not intimidation, but good news. As a cancer tumor must be removed by a radical operation to make a recovery possible, is the end of this world a needed operation to replace this sick world system for the government of the new world, God's kingdom, where so many daily for pray. The prospect is then eternal life. Your body cells will be continued replaced for new ones. No aging process. Your body remains vital. There is no injustice. We read in Isaiah 32 verse 1, "Look, a king will reign for righteousness itself, and as respect princes, they will rule as princes for justice itself. The earth will be filled with happy humans. This is the fulfillment of the original purpose of God's creation of the earth. Humans can live upon the earth forever." What do you want to do? This world is sick. The problems cannot be solved. A radical operation is needed and will take place by God's purpose. This is no intimidation. The end of this world will be a reality. Christ Jesus referred by his signs to the end of this world to the flood in Noah's days. They did not worry for the warnings of Noah. We read in Matthew 24, verse 38 to 39, "They eating and drinking, giving in marriages, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and they took no note until the flood came and swept them all away. So the presence of the Son of Man will be." It is now the time to listen and to react on the words in 2 Corinthians 5 verse 20. "We beg you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God." Listen to the words in 1 John 2 verse 17. "The world is passing away and also its lusts, but the one who does the will of God lives forever." It is your choice. Salvation is dependent of God's approval. It is sure the day of the Lord will come with the end of this world, and then the new world with peace and security will be in reality. More videos with Bible subjects by typing tabib01 and the website thebibletruths.info and the website thebibletruthsweb.info. Thank you for your attention for the truths of the Bible.